Things are so, a little different today. Grab one of these white tickets
and you'll be told the location of today's first golden ticket. Golden ticket can only be claimed when presented with one of these white babies. Woohoo.
This looks like labor.
It's like labor. I think labor's this way. No, actually, it's this way. Nobody's gotten it yet, right?
I'm looking up the address on Google Maps.
104 Delancey.
104 Delancey?
104 Delancey.
All right, thanks, man.
The spot.
All right, just slow down a little bit, guys.
I need your legs, I'm sorry.
What appeals to me about Hanksy's work is his sense of humor. I think that's how he's really reaching everybody, and everyone who doesn't like his work just doesn't get it. You know, it's not serious art. You know, if you even want to call it art, he doesn't even call it art sometimes. He calls it fart. He's making fun of his own work.
Yeah, buddy.
Are you guys going to share it or is it G's?
You know what? I'm going to share it just because I got mine.
Yeah.
We should even it out.
Yeah, we should like even it out.
It all evens out.
It all evens out. This is fucking great, though.
I'm not originally from New York. I was born in the Midwest, bounced around, and came here about 4 years ago. Got laid off 2 weeks after I moved here, and then I decided I'd think of a joke, which was Banksy, and then you take the famous Banksy image, and you take a Tom Hanks's famous mug, and you smash them together. I thought that'd be a funny joke, and I thought it'd be even more hysterical if it actually was on the street. So I put it on the street, and the next day someone snapped a pic and it went viral. And I was like, oh fuck, let's do it again. So I drew up another thing, and then that was successful and got a lot of Instagram posts. And then I ended up getting a weird solo show up the street, actually two blocks from here. And I was like, great, suddenly I'm an artist and people are gonna buy my work, so let's do it. So I did it.
So when I was in Massachusetts last year for February, Valentine's Day, he had this postcard that said, I like to bang ya. And I was on crutches, so I couldn't go to any store to get them. I couldn't come to New York, I couldn't go to Bodega in Boston. So I started Instagramming people to try to get one, and no one would send one. So I came down to New York, and he, I guess, saw on Instagram I was in New York, and he left one for me. That was to me from Hanksy. That was like the coolest thing in the world. Like, he got a fan for life for that.
When I decided to do this show, I was like, okay, you know, I've had a handful of gallery shows in the past, and like, I've had these ideas what I wanted to do with it. And you know, for some reason or another, whether it's money, space, you know, all that other technical bullshit, I couldn't pull it off, you know. And when you're paying 50% of whatever sales to the gallery, I mean, it fucking sucks. So like, let's do it our own. I'm gonna do it myself. I'm gonna do it my own. And I'm gonna, you know, I've had some experience with working with other artists. I'm like, I'm gonna invite a bunch of people and we're gonna paint the walls. And you know, you're gonna walk into this big space and it's gonna be completely transformed. Cause that just really doesn't happen anymore. It doesn't really happen in Lower Manhattan either. So I'm like, let's invite all these artists and like, you know, let's get some fucking arcade games. Let's get a skate ramp. Let's pump this room full of so much visual bullshit that the last thing people want to look at is the art. And because that's the shittiest part, you know.
The work's a little silly and dumb. It's cute looking, but I think it's kind of moronic. As a artist as well, kind of pissed off that it was getting so much play because I thought it was so fucking bad. He understands that it's a joke and that it's stupid and that he's kind of almost playing a game on the art world by making something so horrible and getting over on it.
I understand why people hate me. Like, I got really popular really fast and here I am drawing glorified notebook doodles and people are loving it. And, you know, I got a big following. Just, I mean, I don't know. It's so weird when you get this hate because you've never met these people. You know, like, I'm a very nice guy. I have a warm heart. But when someone writes, like, I wouldn't piss on Hanksy if he was on fire. And I was like, oh, well, shit. Fuck, if I was on fire, you wouldn't put me out with your own urine. Like, fuck, forget it. Like, using a bucket of water. You won't even take your own human waste to put me out to save me from death. And then he followed up with that same commenter said, I hope he gets the cancer. Like, what? I don't know what the future has in store. I mean, like I said, I don't know if I want to be drawing George Clooney holding a banana that looks like a dick and call it Bicurious George. I don't want to be drawing that when I'm 50 years old. So we'll see. Like I said, I'm going to keep doing it while it's fun. Once it stops being fun, then I got to reevaluate the situation. But as long as I'm doing rad shit, I want to keep on doing rad shit. This is my whole MO right now. It's like, fuck, man, I hate Hanksy and I hate his art, but he keeps doing cool shit. So I guess he's not all that bad, you know.